Good day, students. We welcome to the second lesson of the SS1 student, and it's on the topic quadratic expression. Quadratic expression is of this type, which is going to be probably at most three constants, which is a, b, and c. And the significant thing there is that the highest power of the unknown is always 2, and is always broken down into the form which is like order 2, order 1, and order 0. What do I mean by this is order 0? The unknown here is what? Is x. So we have x raised to the power 2, which is the highest power. Then this is x raised to the power 1. If you are very good with your indices, you understand that. And this is x raised to the power 0. And x raised to the power 0 on a normal day is what? Is 1. So 1 times c is still c. So when you realize that the highest power of your unknown in an expression is 2, then you are dealing with a what? A quadratic expression. Alright, you see the way I define it. I said the general term of a quadratic expression is this, where a, b, and c are constant, and x is the unknown variable. So let's look at examples of quadratic expression. Now, see this, x squared minus 9. X squared minus 9 is the same thing as saying x squared minus 0x minus 9. So this is the order 2, order 1, then the order 0. So this is a vivid example of a quadratic expression. Also this, x squared minus 1 over 3x plus 5. It's in the form of this, very perfect, in which in this case a is 1, b is minus 1 over 3, and c is 5. I believe you understand what I'm saying. Now, what I'm trying to bring out in this is that the arrangement of your quadratic expression does not really matter. You can see, in this case, the order 0 comes first, order 1 follows, then the order 2. As long as the definition stands, which is the highest power of your unknown is still 2, then it's still a quadratic expression. Alright now, so let's go to the idea of how to factorize quadratic expression. Alright, I have two examples there that will help you in getting to know how to factorize a quadratic expression. Example 1 says x squared minus 3x plus 2. You need to understand that your quadratic expression is always in three terms. We have the 1 over the 2, that of order 1, and that of order 0. Then you need your idea of product and sum. Just you get to understand what I mean by product and sum soon. The product is always as a result of the order 2 times that of order 0. Just note that order 2 times order 0, the one with power 2 and the one without any letter, or let me say without the letter you are referencing. So x squared times what? Times 2. That is what it says. So you have your result of your product to be 2x squared. You note it. Just take a note of that. Then the sum is always the order 1 term. The one with order 1, which is what? Minus 3x. So what do we want to use these two numbers for? Now this is where you have to do a little brain tussle. What do I mean by you do a little brain tussle? Listen to this statement very well. You are to think of two numbers. You are to think of what? Two numbers. These two numbers will be as a result of the product and sum. What do I mean? The product of these two numbers must give you 2, while the sum of the two numbers must give you minus 3. Now think through. What will be the what? Two numbers. If you think very well, you will see it is what? Minus 2 and what? Minus 1. Right? Alright. So these two numbers are the numbers you are going to use to work on this expression. Now what do you want to do? Let's come down here. Going down to this now, you are to reframe this expression as this. Now what do you observe that happens? I splitted minus 3x to become what? To become those two factors that you've gotten. So minus 3x has now changed to what? Minus 2x and what? Minus x. Then the next thing you do is what? You regroup. You regroup in what sense? The first two term and the last two. The first two and the last two. So from the knowledge of your little factorization, just check through what is common between these first two terms and what is common between the last two terms. In the first two terms, we have x common. So x from this, you have a x left. You know, when you are factorizing, you use whatever you factorize to divide. So that means since I factorize x, x divided square root mean it will have what? X left. Then this is going to be minus 2. I believe you understand what I'm saying. So what is common here? You assume that nothing, but whenever there's nothing common between numbers, for sure one is always common. So it's always advisable when minus is leading, you factorize minus, then that's one that is common. So this minus here, as you are factorizing it, will trigger this plus to become minus, because at the end when you open this bracket, what will it still change to? To change to plus. I believe you understand me. Now what will you do? Then you factorize completely. You factorize it completely. S minus 2 is still common. So factorize S minus 2 from these two terms, then you are left with S minus 2 and what? S minus 1. So that is for the example 1. Let's go to the second example here, which says 5y squared plus 26y plus 5. The same process. I'll be faster now. So you find the product. What's the product? The power order 2 and the order 0. That's 5y squared times what? 5. And you have this, which is 25y squared. Then your sum is the middle term, which is what? 26y squared. So you have to puzzle through your brain, and that is what? Think through. By thinking through, you have it that we have that should be 25y and what? 1y. So 25 times 25. 25 times 1 will give you what? 25. And 25 plus 1 will give you what? 26. So that is exactly that. And you have to use it to split down 25. You have this. You use it to split down 26. And you have this. You regroup. You factorize 5y from the first two terms. And you are left with y plus 5. Nothing is common here, you factorize your 1 out, then you are left with y plus 5. Then finally, you have it factorized as this. Let's go to how to solve quadratic equation. First, ask yourself, do you know the difference between equation and expression? Alright, I think the difference is equal to sign. So the equal to sign makes the wide difference between an expression and equation. So when you have a quadratic expression mixed up to produce an equation, then you have it as quadratic equation. So this is an example of a quadratic equation. You can see that in this sense, you have order 2, order 1, then the order 0 is at the other side. So this is your the left hand side and the right hand side. So also here. Now let's look at this note. When the product of two numbers gives zero, then one or both are zero. Do you understand that? That is, in a situation whereby they ask you a question like, okay, the product of two numbers is zero, what are the numbers? You can be like, okay, the two numbers can be zero, and at the same time you can say what? One of the numbers will surely be what? Zero. That is what gives rise to the solution of a quadratic equation. Now let's look at example one here. Example 1 says 2y squared minus x equals to 1. Then that means that if I want to solve a quadratic equation, I must make sure that the quadratic expression is equal to 0. It is a must. It's not a thing that you can do without. So you must make sure that your quadratic expression is equal to 0. So the best thing is to rearrange to be of this form. So when you rearrange to this, then it's equal to 0. Then we've explained to ourselves how to factorize quadratic expression. So all this is not going to be a magic to you. I believe you understand what I did here. So you have to factorize this. On factorizing this, you get something like this. Now, you are to see through that, all right, that is telling you that the product of two numbers gives rise to zero. That indicates that it's either the first one is zero or the other one is zero. Please note it. Don't write and. And is a statement that is kind of restricting you. Do you get? So it is or. So when you use or, you have played safer enough. So 2x equals minus 1, then s equals 1. Then solving this, you divide both sides by 2. When you divide both sides by 2 here, you have it that x equals to minus 1 over 2, or s is still 1. Let's go to the second example. The second example says 10 plus x squared equals to minus 7x. The same thing, you rearrange to make sure that your expression is 0. So on rearranging, you have it that 10 plus 7x plus x squared is 0. You can factorize like this if you want to do it like that, or you rearrange first to something like this also. Rearranging this, then you then factorize. And you factorize this carefully, that should be a thing that you do on your own. You get something like this. So on factorizing, you have something like this, then you solve. X plus 2 is 0, or X plus 5 is 0. So when you solve this, these are simple equations. So X equals minus 2, and hence equals to what? Minus 5. So let's look at more examples on a quadratic equation. Let's look at this example. Find the ratio of x to y. So the expression you are finding the ratio of x to y is 5x squared plus 26xy plus 5y squared. This was what I was trying to refer to as our former example, that it is the reference letter that you are to consider to be arranged in order 2, order 1, or order 0. You will see here that we have x raised to the power 2, this is x raised to the power 1, and there is no x here, which means you are referring to x raised to the power 0. So factorizing this, you multiply 5x squared times 5y squared, your product and your sum, you factorize, then you result to something like this. Then this is equal to 0, and also this is equal to 0. So that's what results to this. Then from there, we can get our ratio of x and y out from the two equations. So from here, you can divide true by y here, and at the same time you divide true by y here, so you have something like 5x equals to minus y over y over y. Then this will take care of this. So you have 5x over y equals to minus 1. Then you can at the same time multiply both sides by 1 over 5. Then you have your x over y to be equal to minus 1 over 5, which means x ratio y here is minus 1 ratio 5. So when you do that to this, then the same approach you apply to this, and you have something like this. So